This is Dominic. Dominic works at a five-star restaurant called the Pixel Palace. There, some of video games' most popular characters come in to have a drink. Sometimes they share stories and even secrets. For as we all know, what the bartender hears is confidential, isn't it?
So I'm sitting there, tending bar, when in walks one of the big guys himself, Simon Belmont. And I gotta tell you, this guy has been on so many adventures, so many quests, but he looked kind of exhausted. So, make him a drink and I'll say, "Oi, you look more tired than usual." And he says, "Oh, it's all these missions they've been sending me on, you know." And I'll say, "Missions? What kind of missions?" And he says, "Well, after I killed Dracula, you know, for the 12th time, eventually I started to get the reputation of a vampire hunter." And I said, "Well, that kind of makes sense. I mean, you did kill pretty much the king of the vampires." And he said, "That's exactly the problem. I finished on top too early. I mean, after Dracula, what's next? Nothing." And I said, "Well, I don't know. I keep hearing there's vampires all around. I mean, it's sort of a big craze." And he said, "Yeah, well, that's the other part of the problem. You see, the first job I got was to kill this one vampire who I think was a reject from Saved by the Bell or something. I think he's one of those metrosexuals because he used some sort of skin cream that just made him sparkle all over." And I said, I think I know who you're talking about. But why him?" I said, "I thought he was very popular and unpopular at the same time." And he said, "That's exactly it. You see, for a while, they wanted to keep him around because he was supplying so many funny jokes and so much humor on the internet. A whole new genre of internet memes was invented because of this guy. But now, they want me to kill him because nobody will stop making the jokes. It's like the vampire Harlem Shake. It was good for 2 seconds, and then after that, everybody was sick of it." And I said, "Okay, fair enough. Well, what'd you do? Did you stab him through the heart with a steak?" And he says, "No, I found a much more effective way of destroying him." And I said, "How?" He said, "I destroyed his career. Do you ever think he's gonna get another acting gig that's gonna have any dignity to it after that? I don't think so." I said, "Well done." And I said, "Okay, so you did something good for the internet, what's wrong with that?" And he says, "Well, the jobs just haven't been as inspiring as they used to be. I mean, everybody hates vampires now, so they're hiring me to kill as many vampires as possible." I said, "Really, like who?" And he said, "Well, there was this purple one who had an obsession with math. Somebody put a hit out on him, and so I had to do my duty. And it was awkward," he said. "Every single time he stabbed him through the heart, he would count how many times he did it. The even stranger thing," he said, "is that the skeleton of this creature didn't even match his outsides. It was like a 5-digited thing, but I'm getting off track. I asked him, 'Who else did you go after?' He said, 'There was this other strange one who apparently had an obsession with chalk.'" I said, "Chalk? I guess he got that name by advertising a cereal that was nothing but sugar-coated chalk." I thought about that for a second, I went, "Yeah, that makes sense." And I asked him, I said, "Who put the hit out on that one?" He said, "I don't know, a blue guy and a pink guy, and apparently they have an affiliation with this green guy." I try not to ask too many questions, especially with people who look as strange as they do. And I said, "That's pretty cool, you're up there with some of the great vampire slayers then." He said, "Yeah, but maybe I did my job a little too good." I said, "What do you mean?" He said, "Vampires just aren't around anymore. Both the fad and the creatures, they're just both dying. I'm not gonna lie," he says, "I went through some very tough times. I dyed my hair red, I started wearing fur coats. It was a very confusing time." And I said, "Well, geez, what did you do?" And he said, "Luckily, I found Vampire Slayers Anonymous. And I couldn't believe how many Vampire Slayers were going through the exact same thing I was. There was this Van Heckling fellow, some black guy named Blaine, some really eccentric chick called Fluffy, I don't know what her backstory was. But we all came together and said, 'We had a good run, but times change, and it's time to evolve to something else.'" And I said, "Well, good for you, man. So what are you doing with your time now?" And he said, "I'm an exercise trainer." And I said, "Really?" And he said, "Yes, his motto is, 'I whip people into shape.'" And of course, I had a good laugh at the pun. It's a lame pun, but what can you do? He says, "No, no, literally, I whip people into shape. You'd be surprised what a good motivator that is. If they're not running fast enough or lifting those weights, a good lash to the back will really fix that up." And I said, "Well, that sounds disturbingly frightening, but I'm curious. Have you ever thought about going back to vampire slaying?" And he said, "Well, Sometimes I have. When the night is young and the moon is full and I'll see a bat fly by. Which naturally I kill with a dagger, but that's probably just mean of me. I do miss being a vampire slayer. And I told him, I said, well, you ever think about hunting zombies? And he said, the thing with that is, a whip doesn't do very well against zombies. And I said, well, why don't you just upgrade to a shotgun? And he said, what's a shotgun? After I told him there was just a puff of Simon Belmont that used to be there and nothing left after that. I don't know what he's gonna do with the information I give him exactly about shotguns. All I can hope is that he puts it to good use. It doesn't work into his exercise form. Because good God, the people that go there, I think they suffered enough. Almost as bad as the Twilight jokes. You see a lot of strange things as a bartender. You see a lot of strange things at the Pixel Palace. So, I'll see a lot of strange things as a bartender at the Pixel Palace. And that ain't no lie. Swear to it.